Welcome to Rural America Live. I'm Amy Wilson, joined with Dr. Harry Anderson from Total Feeds, as well as 11-time world champion barrel racer Charmayne James. We have lots coming up with Charmayne. First, Dr. Anderson, I would like to set the stage for this show. We're here in Las Vegas at the Convention Center for the Wrangler National Finals Rodeo, and we have lots of news coming up about Total Feeds.
Yes, we do. We've been working real hard this year, and it's been a great year, and we'll talk about that later. But I just want to make one major announcement, and I know some people are going to be a little frustrated with me, because all the years that I have talked about my pretty white bag, that it saved them so much money and everything, well, we are now going to have a change in bag. 1st of January, we'll be coming out with a new bag, and it's going to be kind of colorful and noticeable. As you can see, it's got some pretty colors on it. It has my pretty picture on it, of course, that has to be there. And it's going to tell about, you know, what the company is, what the product is inside, and then on the back side, it will have the basic information that people want to know. So it's kind of basic, but I do want everybody to understand and listen very carefully that this did not increase the cost one penny.
That's great.
We figured out a way to do that. You know, originally it would have cost us quite a bit of money to do this, but we did figure out a way to do it. So that's our big announcement for the end of this year. And we've talked about all the new products that have come out this year, and we're really excited about especially the Total Bird that is the most recent addition to our lineup. And we'll talk about that a little later, but that is really doing some things that are going to set the game bird industry and the backyard poultry industry on its ear.
As we jump right into talking about Total Equine, we're here at the Wrangler National Finals Rodeo. A lot of other events going on where you see what an important partner those equine partners really are. And of course, all year long is an important time to care about your horse's nutrition, but it's winter time, and so there are some concerns at this time of year, of course. What are some questions and answers that you have concerning Total Equine?
Well, for the winter time now, one of the things that always kind of bothers me about winter time management of horses is how early and how much people use blankets. The horses were not designed to have their hair coat compromised. And one of the things, and I've said this every year, I guess, I'm not an advocate of blanketing unless it's very seriously cold, because horses will develop covering. I grew up in northern North Dakota, where it got down to 30 and 40 below. We had horses there, and I never put a blanket on a horse. Now, they would have to be in out of the wind when it's that cold, but if you keep a horse in wintertime out of the wind and have a good hair coat, and when I say good hair coat, I don't mean that big, long, shaggy hair coat. I mean a good, thick, dense hair coat like they develop with Total Equine, and that's one of the things that we're proud of, that we develop a very thick, dense, short hair coat in wintertime, and horses stay a lot warmer without blankets.
Let's also talk about older horses and the care they need.
Yes, older horses, and they're the ones that are going to suffer most in wintertime, so you have to have them prepared. But older horses do not have to look and act old. They may look old, but they don't have to act old anymore. We have discovered that, mm-hmm. And we have a picture of a horse that I just found recently. Now, this horse may not look so great, but Sunny is 40 years old.
Wow.
Sunny is in Mooresville, North Carolina. He's owned by Howard and Leanne Overcash, and they have had him now on Total Equine for 2 years, and even though he's sagging a little and lacking a little bit of that top line, look at that muscle on this horse yet. And one of the comments that they made is he was failing real bad when they started him on Total Equine, but they said it, what their terms were, it put the pep back in his step. And he still gets around, he exercises and feels good, but he's 40 years old, and he may die next week, who knows, but he's going to enjoy life right up to the end. And this is what we can do with these older horses. We've run across this before, where they stay healthy and active, and they're moving around and they're chasing other horses, but one day they lay down and their heart stops. And that's why we want it to happen.
With that being said, we should remind everyone they should take before and after pictures. I know sometimes we don't want to take those before pictures because we're not proud of how a horse looks, but it's important to show the difference that this feed can really make.
Absolutely. And by the way, I love, folks, I love those before and after pictures when you do. People are starting to put those on Facebook because they want the world to see what they've done with their horses because they felt so bad. But we do love those, and we want to see all we can get.
I try to do that. I've sent you mine and told you how impressed I have been. Something you wanted to touch on real quickly was some rumors that you've been hearing.
Well, there's some things going on out there in the industry, and I wish they didn't have to happen, but some of their, not just competitors, but people tend to start spreading false information about. One of them that I really want to discredit is the fact that there's a rumor going around in the upper Midwest that among for a certain group of people that said, well, Total Equine had to increase their price so much that instead of doing that, they just cut the nutrients in it so the horses aren't doing well. Folks, I'm here to tell you, Total Equine has never cut nutrients out of the program. I will never do that. If I have to increase the price, I will increase the price, but I have not compromised the product ever and never will. Thank you.
I'm glad to give out the facts. Also, I want to remind everyone to check out your website, totalfeeds.com, and you're very open to visiting with people. They can find your number, your information on there, and lots of information about all the products you offer. So be sure and check out that website as well. Speaking of nutrition, I want to bring someone in who is so very knowledgeable about this. In 1987, you were wearing the number one back number here at the National Finals Rodeo. In 1990 or 88, everyone might remember you making that phenomenal run to win the round on Scamper without a bridle. It wasn't intentional, but it happened. So a lot of great moments for you here in Las Vegas. It's great to have you here on the show today.
Yeah, no, it's great to be here. That was a lot of fun back in 1988. I'm just glad I survived.
I love watching that video over and over. Dr. Anderson, let's get started talking about nutrition.
Okay, well, I asked Charmayne to be on because Charmayne goes back basically her entire life dealing with nutrition, and she is very knowledgeable about it because she's lived her whole life growing up in a feedlot like you did, Charmayne.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about your background of why you are so tuned into nutrition and how you came to be in communication with us.
Well, I grew up in a feedlot. My dad had a feedlot, so nutrition was very important for our livelihood. And when I started winning on Scamper and doing really well, it was important that Scamper was on a good nutrition program. And Dr. Gordon Wooden worked with my father in the feedlot, and it was always real important that Scamper, you know, had the minerals that he needed. At the time, we were feeding already roasted grain at the time to our horses, so that was very important from the very beginning, before I ever even really hit the road full time, that Scamper was getting those nutrients that he needed. And as the years went on, my father developed the horse feed company, and he no longer does that. I came to you because you made an extruded feed, you have the chelated trace minerals in it, and I just know the importance of that. I would never have won my 11 world championships without a good feeding program and getting the nutrients in those horses where they can absorb it and utilize it properly.
But just to expand a bit on where you came from, I remember your dad's feed yard because I was a feedlot consultant back then. And yes, they were using a process at that time called popping, and they popped Milo and made it look like popcorn. And when they squeezed that down, it was almost like our extruded process today. So that's what you were used to. And I remember you had your own product with that pop Milo in it and was doing very well. So when you could no longer get that pop Milo, you would you needed to come to find something equivalent, and you were savvy enough to know that the extrusion process, which I won't explain right now, most people know about it, was equivalent to that popping. So the digestibility was very critical.
Yes.
Then you also understood that the chelated minerals are very critical. Minerals are the backbone. That's the second leg of the important part of my whole program. First is the digestibility, then is the chelated trace minerals that make everything in the body happen, every reaction started. And so that was very important. And then you probably weren't tuned into it, but I think I added something to your repertoire, and that is the Ascophyllum nodosum, or the seaweed.
Yes.
That we use, that even added on to the effect of everything else that you had been doing all those years.
Yeah, so I'm so blessed to have this feed for my horses, and I teach full-time now at my schools, and so I'm able to pass along, you know, a good feeding program to my students. And I have so many that come up. My horse is doing really great on the Total Equine, and it's so safe and everything that you need. I mean, the main thing is that they don't get too hot, they don't get too low, they stay real balanced, and that's what you really want with the barrel horse, something that's not
right.
all wild and fed up. And you can feed a program knowing they're getting the things they need without having to starve them back. And, you know, you're on this always, oh, they're too hot, then you gotta cool their feed down.
Right.
And so you're not playing with their feed all the time. It's just a good balanced program you can stick with all the time.
You bet. So she understood the basics of what I was trying to do more than probably anybody else I've had call me. And so I'm just so delighted that we're working together because of her knowledge and understanding how she can relate all of this to her students. And, you know, a well-balanced horse is so important.
It really is. I've been sitting here in awe. I enjoy listening to all this. I know, Charmayne, with all of your schools, you get a lot of questions, and I think there's a few that you would like to touch on with Dr. Anderson.
Yeah, so one of the things a lot of the girls ask me is they want to know, can we just feed alfalfa hay, and why do we need to feed anything other than good alfalfa hay? It should have everything in it that you need. So why would it be that you should feed the Total Equine? That's what people ask me. So.
Okay, that's a good question, and I do get that once in a while too. And how I answer that is that alfalfa probably comes the closest of all I know of being the perfect ingredient or the perfect ration. It has a lot, most everything a horse needs in it. However, it does not have exactly the mineral balance it should have, because alfalfa has a way big two spread of calcium phosphorus ratio. So we have to bring that somewhat together to help them keep from having bone problems. The other thing is that the trace mineral package in alfalfa is it has trace minerals. Everything has trace minerals, but we can do so much with added trace minerals, and the trace minerals in alfalfa are not as bioavailable as the ones we use in Total Equine. And then the additives like the ascophaminidosin. You're not going to find that kind of effect of helping the gut health, you know, and the stability of the mind and the extra blood flow and those kinds of things that we talk about from that. You're just not going to get that from alfalfa alone. So we can complement alfalfa. Even though it's very, very good feed, we still can complement it. And you do need it if you're going to get the maximum performance and longevity out of your horse.
Okay, that's great. Okay, so another question I had was, I've had people tell me that when they first start feeding the Total Equine, their horse maybe lost weight when they first initially started it.
That's another good question.
I didn't have that issue, so it makes me wonder, could that possibly be? And you have the answer for that.
It can happen. Yes, I've had these calls, these panic calls from people that after about 2 weeks on, they say, my horse lost a bunch of weight. Well, your horse was fat to start with. And when you go on Total Equine, it immediately starts to burn the fat off the outside of that animal, because the body says, I don't need that cushion of fat. I don't need that insulation, so I'm going to give that up. And when the process, all of a sudden, they see what's under that fat. And a lot of times it's some ribs that they've not seen in a long, long time. And a lot of people, if they see a rib, they panic. But that's not all bad, because you should be able to feel the rib very easily on the side of a horse. If they're really athletic and well muscled, you're going to find that rib. I like to be able to see the rib in the sunlight, just the outline of that rib.
Just a little bit.
They
yeah.
just don't need all that fat on the outside, and that's what's happening. And if they actually measured their horse or weighed their horse and they lost weight, part of it is because all of a sudden the horse is eating less hay and drinking less water to digest that hay. Because for every pound of dry hay they eat, they have to drink 3.5 pounds of water. And in the process, if they stop eating 5 pounds of hay, which isn't uncommon, they're going to give up 15, 16 pounds of water. So now they've lost 20 pounds. You take that with the body fat loss, and I've seen some of these great big quarter horses weighing 1,500 pounds in fat lose 200 pounds. But they gain it all back in muscle.
Okay. Well, that's great. I think that helps a lot.
Yeah.
So, yeah, my students and people out there, I mean, I always tell them they can call you. You talk to anybody.
Yeah.
I know some people are always a little bit scared, but I think it's important that they have access to you, because
yes.
That's where I learned so much from, was from Dr. Wooden and Dr. Richard Godby along the way,
yeah.
helped me out along the way. And and just learning. It's always a process of gaining information, and that you make yourself available
exactly
to people is nice.
Yeah, learning is a continuous process, and I know you've made changes along the way to make sure it's exactly what it needs to be. Yep. I want to remind everyone to check out totalfeeds.com. There are a lot of questions and answers on there as well. So if you have some questions, you can check that out. Look at the ingredients. You can locate a dealer. And of course, if you have more questions, Dr. Anderson welcomes your call and comments about any of the products. Any final thoughts, Charmayne, on any of this?
Well, gosh.
It's been great working with you, Charmayne.
It has been great working with with your whole family.
Yeah.
Your whole family is amazing, and that y'all are just really good people. And I think probably Total Equine and Total Feeds is a family-run company. They're all, the whole family's involved. And you've got good people doing it. They're doing good things out there, and that's important.
I'm glad you brought that up. It is very much a family-involved company, and
yes,
you guys do a great job. Always are smiling and upbeat and involved in so many different things. So.
And the whole family is here right now working the show. So we love this. We love to meet the people. And please, come by and see us. We just enjoy everybody.
Yeah, if you're here in Las Vegas, be sure and come by the Convention Center here in Las Vegas and visit their booth and visit with the whole entire family. You attend a lot of other events throughout the year as well, and they can find those on your website. And we'll talk more about some events later on in this show.
Yes, ma'am.
I mentioned that I try to take before and after pictures.
Yes.
And I've unfortunately, or fortunately, however you want to look at it, been able to see a couple pretty extreme cases. I had one horse that I had sent to someone to sell, and he came back extremely thin and malnourished and even fell getting off the trailer. He was so weak. And I called you and asked, how much can I start by feeding him and what can I do to help him the fastest way possible that's still safe? And he really made a huge turnaround. And so I was very impressed with him. I also had a horse I bought this spring, sight unseen. A friend of mine had ran the horse and made the IFR on him. And so I bought this horse, and he was thin when I got him and not in great shape. And he ended up having an injury right from the start. And so I had given him a lot of time off, of course, started him on Total Equine as soon as I got him. And then once he was healed up, I sent him to be swam for a couple weeks, and he came back and I was so impressed. I think we have the picture for everyone to see, but this is the first horse that came back, and I was just devastated to see his condition. And literally with just in a couple weeks, he started looking so much better. A couple months was the second picture, the after picture, and he just continued to look even better. And the other horse that I had, I had just ridden him that morning. His name is Leo, and I just snapped a picture because I was so impressed with how he looked. Well, now I'm regretting that I didn't at least brush him off before I took some pictures. But this was when I purchased him in April. He had just been clipped. He came from way up in the Northeast, and so it had been pretty cold up there. And like I mentioned, in August then is my after picture, and I was just really, really impressed with the change in that horse. And like I said, I should have brushed him off, but I was so impressed. I just looked at him and thought, wow, I got to show some people this picture. And so this is Leo, and like I said, very impressed with Total Equine and what it's done for my horses personally.
And Leo even changed color.
I know. Yeah, when he first came, he looked so strange because he had been body clipped, but it really helped his whole coat. I mean, it was a drastic change, I thought.
Yeah, we often see this, Amy. We see a change in color. It's amazing. People almost panic when they see horses change in color. We've seen a lot of yellow horses go copper or gold or dark chocolate, and we see the reds go darker and get almost brown. We see buckskins, get a darker and more crisp a variation of hair color. And it's really exciting to see that, because that's the color they should have been.
Yeah.
That's all we're doing, is letting them be the color they should have been already.
I will mention, too, I had a horse that would choke on grain. Her name was Miss Piggy, and she would just devour her grain. And it was really scary a few different times. And once I put her on Total Equine, I never had to worry about it again. I mean, she just ate it right, and she loved it. And they all come running when they hear me coming with grain. My horses absolutely love it. And that's another question I've seen on your website, too. So, again, check out totalfeeds.com if you'd like more information. Charmayne, it's been so great to have you here.
No,
I know Dr. Anderson
you.
Loves
yes.
your partnership.
Yeah,
and
thanks for having me. Thank you, Dr. Anderson.
Thank
it's
you.
Been awesome.
Thank you very much. Well, we're going to head to a break. I'm Amy Wilson, joined by Dr. Harry Anderson with Total Feeds, and we'll be right back with more Rural America Live. Welcome back to Rural America Live. I'm Amy Wilson, joined with Dr. Harry Anderson from Total Feeds. We have so much information to present to everyone, but I know right from the start you have a video you want to show.
Yeah, yes, Amy, I do have a really good video of Joni Volosian. She's from northwestern Colorado, and I found her, I caught her up to her at the World Paint Horse Show. She has some phenomenal stallions that she's bred over the years, the two most famous stallions in the paint horse world, and we've been working with them for a couple of years now, and she has some really, I think, serious comments to make about them, especially reproduction.
Great, well, let's take a look at that video now.
A true Rolex is my number one senior stallion. He is the all-time point-earning stallion in APHA history.
Okay. All
so,
right.
Open point stallion,
okay.
Yeah.
And how many offspring does he have? I know he's getting on in years now.
Oh, like 450 or so.
Well, that's a lot of children.
Yes.
Yeah, he's very prolific then. And that's another a strong point that I think is important to point out, that some of these really great horses are also very prolific. And
Yes, they are.
Good. But you've just, who's this we have here with us?
This is Rolex and Starlight. This is a son of a true Rolex.
Okay.
And he's won 3 world championships in the roping today, the heading, the heeling, and the steer stopping.
Okay.
So he had a great day.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he's been busy with that all day, but he doesn't look tired and wore out.
Oh, no. He likes his job.
Okay. That's important. The great horses love their jobs.
Yep. Yeah, and we've been feeding your feed.
Okay. You like Total Equine?
Yes, I love it.
Why do you like it?
It seems to help with the fertility of the stallions.
Okay.
And it seems to be just such a well-balanced feed that the horses always look good and perform well and feel good. And
okay. Well, he got a good hair coat and good muscling. I guess that's a good test to it.
Yep, and he performed excellent today, so we can give a tribute to your feed.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
We'd love to hear that. Now, I remember in the early on when you started feeding Total Equine, that's been a couple years ago now or so, what prompted you to try it and what did you see? I think you had a problem horse that you were dealing with.
Yeah, I had a horse that was very fractious and it was causing training problems with him. And once we got him on Total Equine for about 6 weeks, and all of a sudden he just calmed down and really started trying and really started performing.
Okay.
And so it just makes a huge difference in their attitude and how well they perform, and they lose a lot of fractiousness. And
So it's not just the muscling and up, just the prettiness of stuff, but there's something mentally going on there too.
Yeah, their concentration really improves when they eat this feed as compared to just being on normal feed.
Okay. All right. Anything else that you've kind of observed along the way that that you feel is important in your business? Because your world depends on these horses doing well.
Yes, it does. My horses have to pay their own way. And so breeding is very important, and fertility is very important in a breeding stallion, especially an older breeding stallion. And I feel that the Total Equine feed just really helps with that and makes it awesome.
That's good to hear. We hear about fertility enhancement in different species with our programs, and we don't hear people talk about it in the equine world that much. I think it's happening, but we just don't hear people talk about it. So
yeah,
I appreciate
Rolex
that.
Is 20 years old now, and his semen is as good as it was when he was a 6-year-old.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, so
that's great, because this is about the time they start to tail off.
Yes, it is, and he's not tailing off yet, but he's still eating the feed.
Well, let's just see how old we can keep him going and how many offspring he can have.
I'm ready.
Maybe
I'm ready to keep working on it.
500 or 600. You think we can make that?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we're going to work on that.
Okay.
Dr. Anderson, I know you love that video, and especially when she talked about reproduction. That's something, and all the great things she talked about your feed, one thing that stood out, I know.
Well, Amy, we've not really dwelt upon reproduction aspects of this for up until recently, when I kind of figured out that we're seeing some phenomenal reproductive things happening in all the species we deal with. So I thought I would try to highlight that, and we're going to hear more about that as we go.
We want to talk about Total Canine.
Yes, Total Canine is working very well. We're getting great reports back on it, from the working dog to the sport dog to all kinds, even the breeding dog. But today I wanted to highlight something we touched on last show, and that was the report from Samantha up in northwest Colorado, talked about the reproduction of one of her females, her stock dogs, that she had a problem with. Every time she had a litter of pups, she would just about disappear. She would just shrink up to nothing. Mm-hmm. And they had to supplement the babies with milk replacer and so on and on. And when she started feeding Total Canine, all of a sudden, the female did not lose weight while she was lactating, and they did not have to supplement the puppies anymore. So I thought, there's something serious here. And then Jana Barkas from Northeast Kansas telling the same story, and we have a picture of the female that she has talked about. This is another one where the people were embarrassed every time she had a set of pups. They were afraid the Humane Society was going to turn them in because she'd get so skinny no matter what they fed. But now they put her on Total Canine, and this is her just as she was weaning a set of pups. And we have a picture of the pups too. And even the pups, aww, this is how well she milks. Because those pups, these are just little tiny babies, and look at how big they are and healthy they look. So that's pretty exciting. And then I just had I called a couple from Illinois that I heard a report on. They have 40 females. This couple is Kenneth and Beverly Keach. And I talked to them a few months ago about Total Canine because they were having some serious problems. Their females just quit getting pregnant. They didn't know what was going on. They were feeding a very good product, so-called product, and there should have been nothing wrong with it, but they just quit having pups. So they decided to try Total Canine, and I talked to them yesterday, and they have Cocker Spaniels, Dachshunds, and Boston Terriers, and they said since they started feeding Total Canine, all of a sudden they have puppies coming at them all the time. There was one female that hadn't bred for 4 years, all of a sudden had a set of pups.
Wow, that is so impressive. I know you've also had great comments about skin and joint health as well.
Yes, the skin problems in dogs is almost an epidemic. All kinds of skin problems, whether it's invasions from insects or allergies or things. We're getting reports all the time how those disappear in just a matter of weeks when they go on Total Canine. And I'm not sure exactly how that's happening, but we're excited about being able to help those poor dogs so they don't suffer so bad.
Of course, Total Canine and all Total Feeds products are available on their website, totalfeeds.com. You can find a dealer, find more information, so we encourage you to visit that website. You also have Total Deer. Let's talk about that for a second.
Well, Total Deer is one we started a couple years ago, and we're getting, we're getting feedback on things that I did not expect to happen. One of the things I reported last show is still going on, but we had a trial where we were able to split twins into two groups, and one twin group stayed on the old feed, one stayed on it, like, you know, research does. After 2 months on the program, they had turned the bucks out on their old program because the horns were hard and quit growing. The blood flow was already stopped to the horn growth, and that's when they turned them out. They still had ours in the pen, and they were still growing way beyond the season when typically they would stop growing. So we were excited about that. But also, the reproduction is something that I think is very important in addition to the horn growth. And Mr. Neil Hughes, we have a video of him that I'd like to show now, talking about the reproductive capacity of the deer on his range.
Let's take a look at that video now.
The first thing we started with the deer, a gentleman did a test with me with Brand X, and we had two protein feeders, and I could touch them, one here and one here. We had the Total Deer and one in Brand X and this one. Well, the deer ate all of the Total Deer. We thought we'd starve them to Brand X so that we wouldn't we couldn't starve them to it. A lot of people told me we're low fence, that mule deer would just come and go. They're nomadic, and we couldn't do anything. But we noticed we had the same deer on camera 3 times a day, 4 times a day. So we weren't losing our mule deer. It was like we had high fenced the place. Where our twins, we didn't have runts. Our deer, the taxidermist that had done the taxidermy work on some of our animals, he said, every year your animal is getting better. Said the base of the horns better. Your overall animal, everything is just getting better.
That was really good to hear. And we've been in that particular ranch long enough to now to know that, yes, the deer are getting better, not just the size of the animal and the size of the antlers, but the reproduction keeps improving. And like he said, they come in with twins. Everybody comes in with twins every year now. And the twins are all the same size because the does are milking so well that there are no runts.
Let's move on to Total Bull and talk about the uses for that product.
Total Bull is, maybe I misnamed it when we started, because Total Bull has a lot of uses, and if we could look at those, I'd just like to run through them fairly quick and talk about how they should be used. But weaning calves, receiving calves, we talked about that on the last show. People are weaning calves on it now and not having any health problems whatsoever for the first 3 weeks while they're weaning. And roping steers and roping calves, you know, how we abuse, I shouldn't say abuse, but how we work those calves so hard, and they're just not old enough to handle a lot of that. But especially these roping calves, these little baby roping calves that weigh 150, 180 pounds, we have found people that we use that, and what happens is the calves stay stronger and they can use them more often. And also they don't have the typical health problems and death loss. And roping steers, if you put it on roping steers, you'll use less steers for an event, and they will steal stronger and run better. But also, one of the things that I'm excited about is the use in donor cows where they're harvesting embryos. The people that have used that on these donor cows tell me that the ovulation rate is about 50% better. And we're going to talk here in a minute about why that is, how we learned that too. But also the egg quality is better. And even though they're more output, the egg quality is better. But then in bulls, if you use this in bulls, the semen quality is better. There's more normal and more viable sperm. So we just think it has a lot of possibilities.
Yeah, the very positive comments about reproduction and all of these.
Right, very important.
Let's touch on Total Goat.
Total Goat is very interesting. That came by someone wanting me to make that. It's been working great in show goats. If someone out there has show goats that they're raising, you will have the firmest, hardest, leanest little goat possible. And that's what everybody tells me. And the other thing is, if you get into a carcass quality situation or a carcass contest, you'll probably always win the contest because it improves carcass quality so very, very much. But again, we have touched on the pre-production capacity. People that have used this and their nannies all tell me about how they have more multiple births. And not only that, they have more births, but the nanny can take care of several more because they're milking so well. So it's the same scenario we've heard in deer and other species.
I don't know if I told you, but I got in the goat business not long ago, so I'll be ordering that too.
Hey, that's wonderful. We'll work with you.
All right. How about Total Bird?
Total Bird is the one that we're excited about now. Yeah. Because we talked last time, and I won't recap all those stories, but how we've seen so much increase in egg production. People are telling us about how there's 50% increase in egg production, the eggs are bigger, and some people are telling us about how they're getting more double yolks of all things, which I didn't expect to be. And by the way, laying eggs is simply ovulation, correct? Ovulation. So here we are talking about reproduction again, because that's all it is
right.
Reproduction. And now on the ranch where we talked about last time how the quail were populating so many times, and they had more hatches this year. Now they called me a couple weeks ago and said, I don't believe this, but we have turkeys coming into those quail feeders. And the owner said, I don't even remember when I've ever seen a turkey on this ranch. So the birds are communicating out there, Amy, and the word is getting out to them. Hey, there's good feed over there, and you better get over there. But the hunters are all telling us that the quail they're harvesting this year are bigger and fatter, and they're flying faster and harder. One guy said, you better be a good shot, because he was out, and he said, I never miss a day without filling my limit. He said, I didn't fill my limit, because they're flying so fast that they're catching me off guard. He said, I've never seen that happen before.
It's So Total Bird is a great product for a variety of birds.
Any bird that walks, whether it's chickens, ducks, turkeys, geese, pheasants, peacocks, we've shown the peacock picture before, they all do extremely well on it, and egg production and fertility is extremely good.
Well, we'll talk more about reproduction as well as Total People. For now, we need to take a break. I'm Amy Wilson, joined by Dr. Harry Anderson with Total Feeds. We'll be right back on Rural America Live. Welcome back to Rural America Live. I'm Amy Wilson, joined with Dr. Harry Anderson from Total Feeds. We're in Las Vegas at Cowboy Christmas. If you're in town, be sure and come by the booth, Total Feeds. If you're not, they can visit the website, totalfeeds.com, give you a call if they have any questions, and find all the products there. Throughout the show, a common theme has been talking about the positive feedback about reproduction.
Yes, I wanted to highlight that because suddenly I realized here not too long ago how many stories I get from all species, and I thought, well, there's something going on here that maybe I don't understand or haven't tuned into. And we do have a list of things that different species of what we hear back, like in Total Equine. You know, we heard Joni Volosian talk about the excellent semen quality and foals that are born with full mane and tail and hard hooves. I get this comment all the time. I just, here at the show, I've had people talk to me about foals being born and how healthy they are and how their mane and tail is fully developed and things. So yes, reproduction is very good in the equine world. And then the total bull, we've talked about the donor cows ovulating more eggs and the bulls with better semen. So a combination like that, you're just going to have more fertile ova and more fertile embryos that we're going to get results from, and that's big dollars in all species, especially in the cattle species, cattle business right now. When they have a good cow, and if they can get 50% more eggs and all those eggs are fertile, why, that's just a lot of money in their pocket and very important. So it may cost a little more per day to do this program, but the end results are still going to bring in more money.
It really is impressive what a good nutritional program can do for all species across the board.
Yes, ma'am. If you're in the business of the purebred animals, and commercial too, but in the lambs, the ewes are having more lambs. Donor ewes produce more ova, and I just had a story recently about a young ewe that they were so proud of that they were going to collect ova from, and the person doing the evaluation of the ova, not only did they have 15 ova from this ewe, and normally would have maybe 10, but the person evaluating under the microscope said he had never seen that percentage of healthy ova, eggs to work with. And so they were very excited. We're going to have results that we'll be reporting on down the road with that particular project. And then Total Goat, we've talked about how nannies have more multiple births and they're able to feed them. So there we go. And then Total Bird, chickens and quail lay larger sized eggs and harder shells and more often. And we have story after story that where people are laughing about how their backyard flock, all of a sudden, they have more eggs than they can get rid of. They have to give them away to everybody because the egg production goes up so dramatically. And then when we talked about the quail operation, when they have more quail than they've ever seen before, have to be coming from more eggs being laid, I would guess, unless I miss my guess.
What great news for the agriculture industry.
Yes, we'd like to help.
Well, you definitely are. Let's turn to the people side of things and talk about Total People Plus.
Okay, Total People is going great, and we're just having a lot of fun with that, especially the stuff we're hearing back from it, but that kind of just a general list of things that we hear and kind of add to it all the time. But one of the things is joint pain in older people going away. That's very, very common. And digestive problems, we get feedback on that all the time. In fact, we're going to have some stories about that, about symptoms of celiac going away, Crohn's disease symptoms easing up. These are autoimmune system problems. And one of the things I think we're finding is that the autoimmune system problems are going to get better because the hormone system in the body must be better. We can relate this back to reproduction. That's hormonally driven. So are these autoimmune things. So obviously the hormone system of the body are being affected very positively. And we talked, told a story. People should look at our last show and talk about Brighton, this young boy, this young athlete that had such a change in life. And then the Warriors and Rodeo, they're going to be here. If someone wants to show up on Tuesday morning at our booth, that'd be tomorrow morning, we're going to have the Warriors, some of the Warriors and Rodeo are telling their stories about how it's helped them physically and with PTSD. And we're so excited about that, being able to do that. But then one of the things that talk kind of like this, I have a video of Mike Lee. He's one of my good supporters, and he has a great story to tell.
Well, let's take a look at Mike Lee right now.
I hit 30, and I have to take Total People Plus, you know. Makes me feel better, gives me more energy, keeps my mind calm so I don't psych myself out. I have to work out, do stupid stuff like yoga, which I never thought I would have to do, you know. But, you know, you got to stretch. When you're 30, life gets real, you know, and pain gets real, so.
Yeah, every year after that, yeah, it takes a little longer to heal. But you mentioned it taking Total People Plus, and has that helped you recover just a little bit more rapidly from all the beatings you take?
I've been taking it for about a year now, and yes, it's very much has. I mean, I've noticed in my mind it keeps me on one level, and I've noticed my lactic acid has been a lot lower, and it don't last as long. I still get sore, but it just don't last as long, so.
Okay, that's great. You haven't had any serious injuries this year, have you?
Just bumps and bruises. I think I got my arm stepped on last year, and I was about like this for about, I don't know, half a year. And I did some rehab, and it came back. A lot of the people said it would never come back, but I had nerve damage, and I guess nerves are pretty hard to deal with. So, you know, I just stayed on my vitamins and did my rehab, and I just refused to say it was not going to come back. So,
well, there's something mental going along there too. There's some tenacity that can help that healing process. But one of the things that Total People Plus does, it does help blood flow, and it does help nerve activity. So it's not surprising that you had a little more rapid recovery from something that we see and hear things in people and animals both. About things that heal up that the medical world has a problem with and they don't think it's going to change, but it does change from the inside when animals or people have the right nutrients.
Horses that you see out in the pasture and they get in a fight, and they have holes in their butts and stuff.
Yeah.
Just like that. I got a hole in my arm from a bull stepping on it, so that wasn't supposed to come back, but it did.
Okay.
That's a big hole in my arm.
Yeah. So it dented right into the muscle.
Yeah, it just squished it. It's gone now.
Okay. That's good. That's good. That's good. Well, any other observations that you would make about Total People?
You know, I think it longevity, it keeps you a young man, you know. It keeps your body on the level it's supposed to be.
If anyone can appreciate the benefits of Total People Plus and the help with joint pain and other pain, it would be a bull rider.
That's right. They get beat up about as bad as anybody. They know they're going to get beat up when they go out
it's
there.
It's expected.
It's a given.
Right, exactly. One thing you mentioned to me earlier was about blood work and how Total People Plus is affecting that.
Yes, Amy, that is something that kind of puzzles me a little bit, but it's so exciting, is people going through trauma, whether it's chemotherapy or whether it's health problems or whether, you know, whatever it is, and their blood profiles go haywire on them, and they have to take medications and things, and the doctors are always checking their blood because they just can't get them right. They go on Total People Plus, and I don't know how many people I've had tell me their blood profiles go right back to normal. Even people that are anemic and can't absorb and have been taking iron shots, all of a sudden their blood iron is good again. For some reason, they're able to absorb it, or they're using it a whole lot better. So we're pretty excited about that. And if there's one thing that can keep us healthy, is having our blood proper, isn't it?
That really is. we have another video that I know you want to share. She's a great friend of RFD TV and also of yours.
Well, this is a radio or an interview I did over the phone with Penny Gilley, because she always has some great stories to tell. So I'd like to let Penny tell her own stories.
Hi, we have Penny Gilley on the line. Penny, it's really great to have you. I know you're a great advocate of Total People Plus, and you've been collecting stories and would like to share some with us.
Absolutely, Dr. Anderson. It's good to be with you today. You know, we're talking to real people out there with real testimonials that really, really are getting a lot of benefit from Total People. Recently, I talked to Betty Campbell from Pennsylvania, who suffers from chronic anemia and for years. And she normally has to go in and get iron shots, and she suffered from fatigue, shortness of breath, brain fog, hair loss. It goes on and on and on. And she has been taking Total People now for nearly 6 months. And she recently went back to her doctor because she's been feeling so much better. And she said that they took her blood levels, and her anemic is intact. Her blood work was good. She says she takes 5 a day, and she is feeling great. And thank you so much. Also, John Thompson from Kansas, he has been buying over-the-counter sleeping aids at night to help him sleep for the longest time. And he said since he's been taking Total People that he's been able to calm down, fall asleep at night, and sleep throughout the night really, really well. He takes 2 a day, twice a day, and says thank you very much. Also, from California, Clyde Warner wanted to tell us that he suffers with neuropathy in his feet and legs, and he said he is 50% better than he has been before, and it's been giving him such relief. Also with his restless leg syndrome, and it's really calmed his movements down at night, and he really, really is thankful for Total People Plus. And he said he's been taking 4 a day, and it's been working great for him.
Well, those are great stories. You mentioned several different things that we hear a lot about. So we're really appreciative that you will share those with us, and we wish you the best and appreciate your time.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Anderson. Thank you for what you do.
They don't get any sweeter than Penny. We wish he was here with us, but the stories about Total People Plus and the positive impact that they're having on people are really endless.
I know. They just keep coming, I hear new ones all the time about what it's helping people with. That's so great. But you know, the one guy mentioned neuropathy. That's a miserable thing. I had a lot of neuropathy when I had chemotherapy 6 years ago, and it was the point where I got so severe I couldn't pick something out of the refrigerator with my hand because I couldn't hold on to it. It would tingle, or my feet would tingle. But as I upped my Total People Plus, that has almost dissipated now. I still have a slight, but probably always will, but it really helps. And I have diabetics talk to me about how their neuropathy that they have to deal with all the time is somewhat better. And that just goes along with increased blood flow is mainly all it is. It keeps those nerves normal and vitalized.
Again, I'll mention that you can check out totalfeeds.com. That's the website. Lots of information on that website about all the products that are offered. Of course, Dr. Anderson welcomes your questions. He gives out his personal cell phone number. So if you would like to give him a call, you're welcome to do that, and he'll visit with you about any of the products. We're in Las Vegas at Cowboy Christmas. It's at the Las Vegas Convention Center. You would love to have people stop by the booth and visit with him that way as well if they're in town.
Absolutely. We just love to talk to the people. And like I said earlier, it's important for us to be able to see our customers. And I think I have discovered over time that people ask me about my marketing program and why it's so effective. And I say, well, if you go out among the people, they can look you in the eye, they can shake your hand and touch you. There's a bond there, and there's a trust that develops immediately, and that's why we spend so much effort. And I think this is at least the 30th show we've done this year, and maybe more, and I don't regret any one of them.
I know at the beginning of the show we mentioned that it's a family company. You're all involved. You're all here in Vegas, actually. And I know you're so appreciative of all the people, especially your family who help, but all the customers and stories. Yes. And all of that.
Oh, yeah. Well, Margaret, you know, my full partner, and Eric, who takes care of all of our logistics and doing a great job on that, and Corey takes care of all of our technical stuff, our websites and those kinds of things, and it's still a family business. I have to contract a little bit outside help with accounting and things, but other than that, we do all the work ourselves, and we're going to continue to do that and make it personal as long as we can. But we've had a great year, Amy. We've had a full year as good as we had last year. Last year was a record year. And I want to thank all of my customers, my dealers, and those loyal people out there that do such a great job of trusting us and using our products and coming back month after month and week after week and staying with us. We so much appreciate that. I just can't tell people how much we appreciate it, as because it's a personal thing with us as well as business. It's a personal thing that we want to take care of.
I know you also would like to thank your distributors and your dealers across the country. And as I've mentioned before in the show, if you would like to locate a dealer, it's easy to do on the website. You just put in your zip code and they'll all show up.
Very simple, very simple. Or if they have a problem with the website, they got my number.
That's exactly right. So the big announcement that we started the show off with was about the new bag.
Yes,
ma'am. Let's take a look at that again in case people didn't see it at the beginning of the show.
Yeah, we're pleased with this. Now, this is the first bag that is coming out. This will be coming out early in January, and so we'll have all Total Equine in it, and other bags and other products will come as we can develop them and get them into the pipeline. Changing a bag like this is not as easy as I thought it would. I thought we'd just change it, but it's taken months to get the design right and find somebody that could do the bag and then get the pipeline filled, and because you have to plan ahead by several months. You know, have a supply on hand before you dare start the first one. But we're really happy to do that.
I also want to thank Charmayne James, who joined us at the beginning of the show. 11-time world champion barrel racer. Just had a phenomenal career with Scamper and other horses as well. And I always think back to the run she made where her bridle fell off, you know, during the run and wearing the number one back number. So many great things that she's done. But as you mentioned, grew up on a feedlot, knows nutrition, and has a great partnership with you now to provide the right nutrition program for her horses.
Yes, yes, ma'am. We really appreciate her. And I know I embarrass her a little bit when I call her the queen. But to me, she is the queen of barrel racing.
She definitely is. Well, let's reiterate some of what we've said throughout the show. Touch on some of the products and specifically the reproduction.
Yes, you know, the total, we have these stories, like we talked about, from Total Equine, Total Bull, or into cows, in the ewes, and in the goat field, all talking about the same story comes from all these species, and that's what made us so confident that we're having something very important going on here anytime, especially in the wild, you know, in the deer population, wild deer population, they have some tough times quite often that can really negatively affect reproduction. Nutrition is so important, but if we can correct that, they're just going to be healthier, and there's more to harvest, and there's more sportsmen for everything, and as well as in the quail business and pheasant business and turkey, wild turkey. If we have more animals that are healthier and reproducing better, we have more sports activity for these outdoors people, and we like to do that. But also economically, that is probably the most important thing we have come up with or talked about in all these species is the reproductive aspect, because that's where the dollars are made.
It really is. It's great news for the agriculture industry, having reproduction be increased and be better, and having great nutritional products that are out there for all different species across the board, and of course for us too. You can find all that information. Totalfeeds.com is the website. Dr. Anderson gives out his number. You can call him on his personal cell phone if you would like to visit with him more, or be sure and stop by his booth. We are in Las Vegas. It's the Wrangler National Finals Rodeo going on here, and we are at Cowboy Christmas. It's in the Las Vegas Convention Center. We thank you so much for joining us tonight. Again, I'm here with Dr. Harry Anderson from Total Feeds. He's involved in a lot of different programs. I mentioned the Wrangler National Finals Rodeo. There's also been barrel racing, match roping, lots of other events going on across the town and across the country. You're involved in a lot of events. So as I mentioned, check out their website. It's totalfeeds.com. For Dr. Harry Anderson, I'm Amy Wilson. We thank you for joining us tonight on Rural America Live. Thank you, Dr. Anderson.